Mini Chapter 9, Jaymi creates Amber's code. Jaymi sips his cherry schnapps on ice, puts it down beside him with a clink of glass on the flagstones of his study terrace, and claps his hands together. He gazes around him through the colours and cool of the evening sky, then pauses at the sound of some unidentified little beast whose call is emanating from somewhere down in the foliage of Laurel Canyon. What can it be? No dog or cat, but a wilder thing. Raccoon? Opossum? Skunk? Fox? It chuckles up a guttural gibber for a few seconds, then subsides into watchful silence, hidden out there in the undergrowth, awaiting whatever Jaymi creates, as if to judge him against some obscure set of harshly mocking standards. Narrowing his eyes at the keyboard, he consults the general sketch of Amber in his design for the Platinum Raven. It reads, quote, "The Platinum Raven's conspirator in this tower in the mountains is named Amber, whose infernal nature and allure reflect the fact that he just happens to be the continuation of Rutger Hauer's psychopathic character in the film The Hitcher," unquote. Well, okay then, bring it on. With that sort of origin, this should be a good start. A character who'll enable Jaymi to exact a smattering of vengeance wherever it may be called for in the game. Yes, this Amber will be well equipped to do a little dirty work for him, targeting whoever deserves it. As he gears up to create this brand new creature, triggering it from a point of singularity and zero-scented vacuum out into one-scented being and presence, Jaymi feels as if he's installing himself behind a complex bank of electronic controls comprising dozens of dials, switches, buttons, parallel rows of faders, and small red or green lights set into matte or shiny surfaces of black metal and plastic. These imaginary decks, looming up before him on the terrace, are way bigger and more powerful than just the laptop computer sitting in front of him running games programming software. That well-worn little keyboard is merely plugged into an extension lead coiling into the house behind him, whereas these darker amber controls feel as if they are plugged into the unfathomable voltage of the expanse of Los Angeles ahead, spreading its electrical vastness in grid lines of yellow and white through the night to the haze of the far horizon. As he watches, the shadowy controls seem to hang in semi-transparent array over the lower third of the cityscape, while this new beast's first sparks of independent being and volition appear in the grain of the upper two-thirds. The elements of him flicker up, each new one joining those that came before, easing into its appointed position of harmony or disruption, until an interlocking array of amber code leaps in vaunting stabs of light and sound, coalescing into an ever-enriching symphonic machinery. The ones and zeros swirl and proliferate in his laptop, like cells suspended in fluid between two glass slides under a microscope. Almost as if already aware of its creator, and sensing its own origins in his urge for vengeance on all that's epitomised in Ain't They Freaky, Amber's code appears to spin and coil back up towards Jaymi, sealed and constrained only by the plastic surface of the screen. Jaymi recoils for a second, then he grins.